Aloha, I'm Sienna Agudong from Upside Down Magic, and you're watching Disney Channel.
Rena, we're here!
Welcome to Sage Academy! You've been accepted to the world's greatest magic school for the world's greatest magic students. Sage has five distinct schools: Fuzzies, Flickers, Flyers, Fluxers, and Flares.
I wish I just had a little more control over wacko animals I turn into.
Was there some llama in there? It felt like a little bit of llama.
By now, you're probably very clear as to which school you are in.
Oh, you look awesome. What does yours say?
UDM. What's a UDM?
Welcome to the School of Upside Down Magic.
So UDM means?
Upside Down Magic. Because you're wonky, and you're weird, and your magic is defective.
But we get to do magic, though, right?
No, we do not.
Why can't we study magic?
Because your magic is the perfect host for shadow magic. And UDMs are its sole target. You will stay down here. You will not practice magic. And your magic will die.
Come on! I'm gonna get there. I'm gonna prove to the entire faculty that we can be taught. We can do things the right side up way.
You can be the shadow.
She is your best opportunity to fall even further behind.
Lord, we need to keep you here to protect humanity.
It's the big day, Alex.
Think I'm ready. Got any tips for me?
The team cut her.
Welcome to Crush Tryouts. I've seen enough.
But playing for Crush is my dream.
Sometimes dreams die.
Her family ignored her.
Can I get a ride today?
Hold on, honey. Hello?
Yes.
Thank you.
I'm gonna go move to Alaska and join a cult.
We are proud of him. He's a great kid.
Looking forward to it.
Then Alex Morgan came out of nowhere.
You're Alex Morgan. I know everything about you. I'm your biggest fan.
Do you know that I grew up in
Diamond Bar? And your favorite color is pink, your favorite food is Mexican, your favorite song is Man in the Mirror by Michael Jackson.
Wow, I don't even think my mom knows all that.
What are you doing here?
You said you wanted some tips.
You're gonna train me?
Let's get started.
Now she's got a shot.
Good. Good, turn around. Keep going, and done. Oh.
At overcoming the odds.
You gotta plan a team this season.
My friend's cousin, she plays for a small club. They need one more player.
Oh, you gotta dive, Lexi!
Allergies are acting up.
She's allergic.
To what? Grass.
Soccer goalie allergic to grass.
Maybe I could be a champion too.
I was just a kid with a dream, like you right now.
Join soccer superstar Alex Morgan in Alex and Me.
People say I'm too nice to lie, to cheat, to steal, but they have no idea. Do it.
Hey, there's Nick.
Nick?
Nick.
Nick.
You have to keep your head in the game. It's easy to get distracted.
Hi, I'm Will.
The lies are piling up.
Nick's the best we've ever seen. The girl in this photo isn't Nick.
It's gotta be a mistake.
I can't believe we're this close to finally finding out the truth.
Easy. But I've got a new plan to get our lives back.
The bank's new intern is my daughter.
She is the best. I've never been so proud.
Thanks, Dad. The stakes are higher than ever.
I'm just used to being the only daughter.
She's my best friend, but there's no way I could hurt the Thompsons without hurting Molly. Make the right moves.
We'll know the truth about Nick by the end of the day.
Everyone is entitled to their secrets. We get to share them at our own time, or not at all. If you think you know what's coming, you have no idea. I'm Nick, and I'm still up to no good.
Hey.
Thanks for coming.
Of course. Where is he?
He didn't come home last night. I'm sure it's fine. But what if it's not?
Hello, Kauai and everyone in Hawaii. I am very, very excited. Oh my goodness. Aloha. I'm SIENA AGUDONG. I am 16 years old and I am an actress and I'm very excited. You may have recently seen me on projects that have just come out. No Good Nick on Netflix. I play Nick and Reina in Disney Channel's new original movie, Upside Down Magic. This is crazy. I'm so happy. I love Kauai. I love Hawaii. This is gonna be fun. So I have a Q&A and some questions I will be answering. Starting with, it's right here, so you know if I look down. What inspired you to be an actor, and how much do you feel like you have accomplished so far? What inspired me to become an actor was honestly my sister. And I tell this story all the time, but this is just how I got started. I watched her do, I'm her little sister, and I have three big sisters. And so, you know, as a little sister, you kind of follow in your sister's footsteps. But I actually was able to do plays because she started out doing plays in Hawaii Children's Theater. And I followed in her footsteps. I did the same thing. I started out doing Willy Wonka. That was my first play, I believe. And that's like really what inspired me, because I really loved it. And I was like, I want to do this, and this is what I want to pursue in my life, and I just, like, I'm really happy. That's basically what inspired me, and, you know, just being around that environment is just so, it's so cool. And how much do I feel like I've accomplished so far? I feel like I have, like, a lot of goals for myself, and I really want to work hard, and I want to get to be in an action movie one day, superhero, crazy stunts, all of that stuff. So that's really where I want to be, and I'm not quite sure what I want to do, but I have a lot of passions in the industry itself. I love writing. My mom's always like, one day I hope you're a director, but they do a lot, so I don't know how I could handle that, but I just think something amongst those lines is really cool, and just the industry itself is like really, it's really powerful, and there's a lot of hardworking people, and I'm just very, it's really cool to be around those types of people every day. So how much do I feel like I've accomplished in the short answer? I'm really proud and I'm really like happy and excited for what's to come, but I'm nowhere near done because there's much more things that I want to be able to do, but I'm very grateful for everything I've gotten. How did I get into acting and where to find auditions? How I got into acting was besides the play. After that, I actually went to a workshop that right now my manager, Susie Maines, was hosting in Hawaii, which is super crazy. And then I met her and she was like, well, if you come to LA, let me know and I'd love to pick you up as clients. So we did, and we auditioned for her, and she picked my sister and I up as her clients. And from there, we auditioned for our agents, and they picked us up, AEFH Talent, thank you. And we started auditioning. And since then, you know, you can't really hold yourself to like book the first one, but who knows? But it takes a lot of time. And I got to auditions, I started booking, and that's when it all started happening. But took many classes, I still do. And then as of right now, I actually just signed with another agency, and I'm very excited, Gersh Agency. So there's like a different steps that you can take like throughout your career to begin. So yay. And then how you can get started. Definitely there's so many things you can be doing even if you don't live in LA. Especially for people out in Hawaii. The distance is very intimidating sometimes because we're in Hawaii, right? So it's like, oh my goodness, like we're miles away from Hollywood. How is this gonna happen? But I did a lot of Skype coaching. Theater, I cannot tell you enough like how helpful it is just for your confidence and really just seeing how everything works. Very different styles of acting, but the comfortability you have to have within yourself, and also just like memorizing and all those technical things, there's a lot of similarities that will help you get started. But that, and also you can look up self-submission, how you can like submit self-tapes to casting directors, and for projects, like they'll send you out for like, you've got a match. And you can look at like what roles you feel like you could fit, and then you submit a tape. Definitely look into that. That's some ways you can do it. But never stop working hard. And know that it does take time. Why did I love filming Upside Down Magic? There were so many things to say about that project. Upside Down Magic was probably one of the biggest projects I've worked on, technology-wise, I guess you would say. I don't know if that's really right to say, but there was like cranes and cranes on set. I remember one day we had a scene, spoiler alert, where it was the Founders Day scene, and there was like a lot of stunts, and I was a shadow magic that day, so there was five days of shooting a scene, and like three or four cranes holding up like tarps and like certain things that were just like, wow, this is insane. And there's so many special effects, and the powers were really cool. I got to get lined up, like lined through my arms with wires for my magic powers, for my fire powers. And also I got to be evil. So I got to be like this villain at the same time as being like a hero. And so playing someone who gets like possessed is just like, there's nothing like it, you know, like what? So playing a character is like that. It's like, I love playing complex characters, and I got to wear black eye contacts. Freaked myself out when I would go to the mirror, like in like the bathroom, and I like looked in the mirror. It was just like, I got scared myself, and I would forget I'm wearing them, because I'd go down through set, and I'd walk through set, and then people would be like, oh my gosh, like scared me, you know, because it's like, when you look at them, it's like, it feels like your whole eye up. Crazy. Favorite memory from set? I have so many, but I would definitely say like working with animals is always so cool, because like they're so unpredictable. So anything with animals is like really fun. I got to see a porcupine on set. They're huge. Favorite memory on set? I'd probably say Alex and me, any of those times, because there were so many like crazy things that had to go into it. And like Alex Morgan, a Olympic gold medalist soccer player, she played Alex in Alex and Me, and she got to teach me a lot of soccer things, and I love soccer. But you know, filming a sports movie was pretty crazy. I remember, oh my goodness, I just remembered something. I remember one of the scenes we had to do, I had to run down a field, and then like getting the pacing right, where you have to look like you're running when you're really like not. Like sometimes it was like, and then sometimes it was like this, because they were on like this go-kart majiggy car thing where they had like the camera mounted onto the motorized vehicle. Yeah. And then so they drive with me as I'm running. So like having to keep up and like not go too fast, where you get out of the frame or too slow. So that was fun. But, and then No Good Nick. I mean, like I got to do stunts. I got to climb through an air vent and like hang out of it and like switch camera wires. It was pretty cool. But I think like it's so hard to choose, because there's so many like different things from each project that are insane. How did you handle people who said you couldn't do it? So I've been very lucky to be around like really nice and kind people, and that's so important, is to surround yourself with really awesome people, and I've just been very blessed. But I mean, you know, I've definitely like gotten some, I've definitely met some people who may have not been like the kindest, or who doubted me and like made it clear, or like said I wasn't ready. In other words, you know, it's just like, it's hard and it hurts, but ultimately this is your dream and this is your life. And if this is what you love, why do you let somebody else's opinion like affect it? Like what matters is yourself. It does. I mean, and of course, like the way you treat people, that's a given, but it matters like how you talk to yourself in your head. And just because someone says you can't do a certain thing, they don't know your capability in your heart, and they don't know the burning passion you have. And what matters is how hard you work. Somebody can doubt you, but if you don't doubt yourself, that's what's powerful. And you can't, you know, you can't like sit there dwelling about what someone said because they're not you. And you got this, and you have to work hard, and you have to realize the sacrifices. And if someone judges you like that, you just can't look back at it and be like, but what if they're right? Or what if I can't do it? What's the point? This is your life. Enjoy it. Live it the way you want to do it. But be kind to yourself and be kind to everybody around you. I always say it, but very important. How did I handle it? Just working hard, honestly, and realizing that this is my passion. And I say, you know what? Like, I believe I can do it. And I know how hard I will work to do this. And you just have to be committed, honestly. And you have to be grateful and humble. Okay. Tips to get into the acting world. The industry itself is huge. There are national searches to get roles. So with that said, there can be thousands of people auditioning for your role, or hundreds, or 10. Who knows? I don't know. 10's probably like way too little, but you get the point. So it's really hard to say, but the mistake a lot of people and myself fall into is getting on myself for not booking a role. But with like, ultimately, like, if you didn't book a role, don't be hard on yourself. Really, don't. There's so many other roles. Yes, that one may have been insane and so fun and this, but that just wasn't yours. And you just have to realize that, like, everybody has their path. And if that's not the role you get, that's not the role you get. And move on, you know, move on, but enjoy the process. Don't just focus so much on booking one thing that you don't enjoy the process, because you have to love it all. This is ultimately, like, the moment, my dad used to say, the moment it becomes work, it's not healthy. And I love it. It does not seem like work. The other day I told my mom I was saying something like, I forgot what I was talking about, but oh yeah, like I needed, oh yeah, I think I need to get like, I don't know. I need to print my script for work. And I just looked at it and I was like, oh my goodness, that sounded so weird. I've never really like said like work, you know, I always say like, I don't know, it just doesn't feel like it. So that's what's still healthy for me, is I really love it. But believing in yourself, supporting yourself, working really hard, and realizing there are so many sacrifices that you have to make. Balancing out your school. School is very important. You cannot work if you don't get good grades, because they won't issue you your work permit. So you have to work really hard in every aspect of your life, and you have to be grateful for everybody. And you have to look around when you're on set, and you have to appreciate everyone around you, because they work so incredibly hard. I respect them very much. But my tips would also be from the beginning of this video, talking about self-submission. That's really important. Also taking a lot of acting classes. Working on it by yourself too. Practice scenes, or practice things that you see like from certain shows. What goes on behind the scenes? This is one of my favorite questions. I can't tell you how hard the crew works, and the producers and directors and writers, like everybody who goes into it. I've been so lucky to be around the most loving and caring sets. They become my family, along with my family, that when I leave set, I feel like a part of my heart is still there, and I can't wait to wake up and go back to set. The like, No Good Nick was so amazing because of, you know, we were there with each other on set. You were there with each other every day, and this set was just so beautiful because we all played together. We all laughed so hard that at the end of the day, like, my stomach would hurt from laughing. They even had their own baseball team that they'd play on weekends. Basically, there's just a lot that goes on, but, you know, it's very fast moving. Oh my goodness, if they're like, okay, we're gonna turn it around, which just means they're gonna flip the cameras around to get different shots, then everybody just starts doom, 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 like, quickly, all of a sudden, in 5 minutes, all of the equipment is turned and everything is, the lighting is back. And the moment they're like, okay, let's do a run through, people are like, you're going through the scenes, and while you're going through the scenes, someone's marking your things by your feet, and like, the director's taking notes, people are taking notes, network's watching. It's just this huge cycle and machine, this like, I wish we had more videos showing on what goes on behind the scenes, but they work so hard. That's what you gotta know, and you gotta appreciate every one of the cast members and every one of the crew members, because the things they do is superhuman. Also, fun fact, like, studio sets are super cold. Okay, how did I find my passion? Theater, that's how I found my passion, and I knew it right away. I just could feel it in my heart. What are my favorite hobbies? Well, living in Hawaii, I spend a lot of time outside. Love to surf, but don't get me wrong, I'm not no professional, but you know, it's just something I like to do. But I'm still learning. And hiking, I love hiking so much. I honestly love like doing new things all the time, hanging out with my family, and then when Corona's out, when Corona's gone, hang out with my friends. You know, doing a lot of sports. You know, unfortunately with acting, you can't really commit to a sport because you can't be there, and you know, you have auditions or you have tapings or you'll leave the next day for acting. But playing like with my friends or playing like with a team sometimes, like I still have people that will invite me to hang out with them or play with them, which is really nice. But anything active, I love. And gosh, what else? I take singing lessons, and so that's really fun. I love dancing in my room too. Weirdest thing I've ever had to do for acting. There are so many things. I remember when I was on Nickelodeon for Star Falls, they threw mashed potatoes in my face, sausages, so many things. I got to wear an owl costume and yell around the town. And then I got to get covered in spider webs and leaves and dirt and roll around in it. I had to face plant in mud because I got dragged by dogs in the scene, climbed through an air vent in No Good Nick. I had a food fight in Nicky, Ricky, Dicky and Dawn, one with candy and then one with Thanksgiving food. That was nasty. And then for Alex and me, like, I had to hit my head on a sign or something, and then I had to learn how to shoot with my left foot, which was really weird. But gosh, I mean, it's something weird in everything. Very, very, very weird. But that was really fun for me. Who do I wanna work with? Tom Hanks is so incredibly talented, and just his performances and everything is just like breathtaking. Sully, Castaway, Forrest Gump, like his classics are just, I respect him so much, and I want to learn from him, and I just want to like listen to him speak and give advice. I just think he's incredible. Sandra Bullock's also incredible. I loved her in Ocean's 8. Robert Downey Jr. seems like a really cool person, and I just can't imagine like working with him and like how inspiring it would be. Who else? Robert Zemeckis, the director, he's so talented, and the things that he's done, it was just crazy. I think I think those are my inspirations right now, but crossing fingers. And The Rock, hello The Rock. The Rock, yeah. Let us see. He's also from Hawaii, I think. What's my motivation for helping the environment? This is so important. I cannot stress this enough. This is our earth. It is. This is our earth, and if we don't take care of it, what the heck is gonna happen? It is our duty. I mean, we're humans living in this crazy atmosphere that somehow perfectly suits humans and organisms for us all to live on it. I mean, not to be all sciencey, but like it does, and it's insane and it's magical, and we need to take care of it. And the sad part is there's so many ways we could be doing it, but a lot of us are looking over it and don't want to listen. So my motivation is for like my future family and for the animals that will be going extinct if this doesn't change. I mean, my motivation is that this is life and this is where we live, and we should be taking care of it, and wanting to breathe fresh air and plant more plants. This is fake, but this is inside. And plant more plants is definitely very important. Recycling and caring about the environment. Really, like, when you see certain posts with, like, resources and information, please don't skip over it just to see, like, the next video of, like, a dance or something. Like, I'm just saying, like, please take the time to learn and be open-minded so that you can learn and see, like, what's actually going on in the world. And, you know, the moment we start listening, like, the louder our voices will get, and the more change that will happen, and the healthier we will all be, and the more beautiful our earth would be. So please, for the sake of your future family and your kids and your loved ones, we don't want to wear masks like in 2070 because of how bad the air quality is, and we don't want to see our animals go extinct, please. What Harry Potter house am I? Completely different question. That's so funny you asked this, because I just took my, the quiz. I found out I'm a Gryffindor. And I surprised myself, because I'm thinking, like, for me, I feel like I'd be like a Hufflepuff. But, like, I'm surprised. I've only watched one movie of Harry Potter, so I have to, like, watch more to realize. But, yeah, I'm a Gryffindor. Was it easy to start my career? No, I mean, honestly, it's tough. It's really tough, but you have to love it. You do. You have to love it. And I love it. And that is what is awesome. There's a lot of things that you have to sacrifice, and I'm continuing to learn that, you know, and you have to work really hard in school, like I said. So balancing your life, your personal, your mental health, your physical health too. You won't have much time to exercise sometimes, so you have to make it in. Your family life, your friend life, your school life. You know, there's a lot of things you have to sacrifice. But then again, the incredible opportunities and experiences that I've gotten to do and experience have just been worth it. And I've just been able to do certain things that it's like, wow, I cannot believe I just did that, or I cannot believe I booked this or filmed this or got to do this or met this person. It's like mind-blowing to me. But starting your career, you'll get lots of no's, so you have to be really strong in your head, and that's something I'm continuing to learn. You have to work really hard. You really do. I mean, there's a lot of work that goes into it. A lot of people will think that, like, hey, you're so lucky, but of course, you're blessed, and you got, like, and you have blessings, and you're grateful, but a lot of it does come from hard work, and staying humble is really important. But also, it's like, you have to stay strong and believe in yourself. And, you know, for a lot of us, it can be hard. I get it. But you really do. That's what I would say. Is it easy? No. Do I still love it? Yes. Like, getting the things you want is not going to just be handed to you. You have to work for it. And let me tell you, though, hold on. When you work for it and you get a dream and you accomplish a goal, how good does that feel? How good does that feel? It feels so good. And it feels like it's like, hey, I just did that. You know, and if it was handed to you, you're not gonna, you know, I'm sure you wouldn't have, like, been as, like, oh my gosh, you know? So, in my opinion, I think it's all worth it. Just take care of yourself and take care of everybody around you. Don't ever let it get to your head. Let's see. Next projects! Okay, I have two movies coming out in 2021. Very excited. Actually, no. I know that one is coming out in 2021. Don't count me out on the next one. Let us in. I'm not sure when it's airing. But it is an indie film. I'm very excited. I play Scarlett, a mean girl. And this is going to be super fun. The next one is a big blockbuster franchise I cannot say anything about. That's all I'm gonna say, but I'm very excited, and it's coming out in 2021, so make sure to follow my social media so you can check it out and stay tuned to see what it is. Crazy crush stories. I'm not gonna name anybody, but I've had I've had like really, if you meet me in person, like I could be very hyper. I could be like awkward or shy, or I guess you just, everybody goes through their daily whatever. But you know, definitely when it comes to crushes, I'm not very good at that stuff. I fell into a trash can once in school when I was going to school, and I remember I was like in front of one of my crushes. I don't even remember who it was. And so that was one of them. I like literally fell into a trash can. Like, I just remember I was wearing boots and I like decided to, oh, you know what? I'm gonna be cool. I'm gonna jump over this pillow. Didn't end up jumping over the pillow. I tripped on my own feet and fell into a trash can, like something out of a movie. I think that's really like my own crazy stuff. Like the amount of embarrassing stories I could tell you. Oh my goodness, not telling you. Sorry. okay. What motivates you? Oh my gosh. You know, I love this question. I have a lot of things that motivate me, but ultimately it's really just because I have this like burning desire to better myself in a lot of ways, and I want to be able to like improve and learn things and do certain things. Like, I want to be able to do a lot. And so that could get difficult, I'm sure, for anyone who holds themselves to high standards. It's hard, and it's like you have to give yourself a break sometimes and like all that stuff. But what motivates me is like all of the excitement in life. And sometimes we're so quick to do things, you know, I gotta do this, I gotta book my project like that so quickly, and snap, 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 this, snap, 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 that. But slowing down and really taking in all of the excitements in life that you're gonna get, like, be able to experience, you know, like, if you're my age, if you're 16 or a teenager or younger, or even as young adults, I mean, and on, like, there's so many more things you can experience, and realizing that you have so many more ways to grow. So you never just stop. I mean, that's what keeps the excitement going, is realizing that your life doesn't just end. It's like, you can't just hit a wall with your career or your personal life or your friend life or whatever. It's constantly changing, you know? And so realizing it and finding happiness and finding joy in certain things. Like me, I love mornings. And if you're not a morning person, if you're a night person and you love nights, or maybe you like afternoons when the sun is shining, take advantage of it and find these little beauties in life that like can excite you, you know? I'm so excited like to be older, but I'm also like really not, you know? There's so many more things and more responsibilities, like taxes and stuff, that I don't want to have to like learn right now. But, you know, like, live in the moment. And what should motivate you is, at least for me, it's like all of the exciting things you will experience and exciting people you will meet, like getting married or having a family or going bungee jumping and going skydiving and playing sports and having coffee dates, you know, all these things. It's like little excitements here and there. You gotta tell yourself, you know. First audition I have, I don't remember, but I still have a video of when I was little. I would every time my sister would get an audition, this was before I really started getting auditions, but every time my sister would get an audition, I would take her script after she filmed it, and I would refilm it for myself and reenact her scene. And I remember there's this video of me like saying all her lines and like being all acting all crazy, but I guess that's one of them. But I still remember all the lines. It was like something about spaghetti all over the wall. It was like, Casey, where did you get the spaghetti all over the wall? It's like crazy without context, but I guess that's what I remember. Okay, my role model and why. My role model, my family. I love my family, and I think there's so many beautiful things about them that I just am really proud of, and I love them a lot. So they're definitely like my inspiration. Besides acting, what else do I want to do? As I said before, I have so many passions. I want to be able to help the animals in some way, perhaps volunteer in many places, and if I could, you know, do that on a regular basis, that would be awesome, and have the time to do that. And also, like, I'm not sure yet. I love writing, like I said, and a lot of things in the industry, but I want to help out the world, and I want to do a lot of things that I'm still figuring out, and I don't want to say it yet until I can get it all figured out. But helping out the world, very vague, but that's where I want to go in addition to acting. Okay. Since you are fit, are you considering an action movie where you do your own stunts? Can I tell you, that is my dream project, to do my own stunts. For as much as production will allow me and like not get hurt, but I think it's so cool. I grew up doing parkour and gymnastics and lots of sports, but of course I had to stop. But I'm getting back into it. So being able to do my own stunts is so cool. I used to want to be like a stunt person, but like I forgot who does their own stunts. We feel like we were just watching it the other day. But I think that would be really cool, and I want to be in an action movie, and I'm manifesting it. Are you a leader or a worker in a group, and which do I prefer? My first thought is like school groups. I guess in that aspect, I love vision, and I love having a vision, and I like to like see things. But so I guess I would love to be a leader, but I think everybody loves it when it's like when there's like teamwork involved. So I mean, everybody has to be open-minded. So I guess a mix of both, honestly, is like of course I want to be able to like rely on other people and like and listen to their input, because multiple interpretations is always important, and like you get to see it from everybody's view. So a mix of both. As a boy, how do I start acting? I'm gonna tell you this, does not matter your gender. It is so important to never put yourself in that, like, it's going to be harder no matter what gender. So many boy actors. So I'm just going to say, same thing as before, believe in yourself, get started with self-submissions, coach, get, like, Skype coaching or workshops, or download monologues from online and rehearse it for yourself if you can't, if you don't have someone to do it with you. Join theater. Very important. But you got this, I believe in you. Gosh, one thing to do before I die. It's kind of dramatic. I feel like skydiving, even though I'm gonna be like really scared. Skydiving, going to Thailand with my family, rescuing animals. I'm gonna have to think about that too. Okay. How did I get my first role? My first role was ABC's Killer Woman. This is a Texas Ranger show. Filmed it in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and the pilot in Texas. And I don't even remember, but I do remember auditioning for it. And then the next night or that night, they called us and they were like, hey, we were just about to leave that week too. And they go, hey, we need you and Sienna to fly over to Texas tomorrow and pack your bags so that you can film the pilot. And we were like, oh my gosh. That's how I booked it. It's kind of vague, but I was like 8 years old. And how do you ask that question? Because this is my director's chair from Killer Woman. And it's basically says my name. And then on the back, I'll show you if I have time. Okay, here you go. Can you see it? It says Killer Woman. Ta-da! That's what that looks like. Basically, it was a band that I got to take. I didn't take the whole chair from Texas, but I got to take the band that covers it, and then we just got this piece. But I've had it since I was 8, and it's a little crispy. let's see. Do I just like Nick Franzelli in real life? I absolutely do. I got to keep a lot of her clothes, which was really cool. So I definitely dress like her. Funny things is sometimes we'd accidentally take pieces. My mom would accidentally take pieces from set, assuming it was mine. So we have to like return it. And sometimes they'd get confused, like which one was my pants and Nick's, because I had like the same ones. What do you do getting out of your comfort zone? Oh my goodness, that's such a hard question for me, because sometimes I stay in that, you know, but acting always brings me out of it, because it's like you can't ever judge yourself. How I get out of my comfort zone? Do something every day that scares you. And I'm not saying something dramatic and crazy and reckless, you know. You do you, but be kind to people and stay safe. But, you know, I guess it's just like little things. Like, I used to tell myself when I go to like dance classes, very nerve-wracking for me, very like beginner, and I still learn, but you know, it gets really nerve-wracking, like if you're in there and you keep thinking like everybody around you watching, like, no, why would they want to watch with you when they're trying to like learn the dance themselves, like, you know? And so doing something that scares me is like as simple as going in the front row rather than the back, or the second row when we're like, you know, when you're learning the dance, because it's like it gets my heart beating, you know? So I'm like, oh my goodness, you know? So I guess just little things here and there that will get you out of comfort zone. Yeah, I guess that. Also, don't judge yourself. And don't stop worrying about what others think of you. It's about time that you realize this is your life and you gotta enjoy it. But, you know, be a good person. Who is my favorite superhero? I have two questionable superheroes, because I'm not sure if they're, like, superheroes, but they're also, like, villains. So, like, Deadpool and Venom. I love their movies because I think it's so funny. And I love Iron Man and Ant-Man, because Robert Downey Jr. and Paul Rudd, love them. That's all, actually. Okay, wait. Something I want to say. Okay. I guess the overall thing, I got a lot of questions regarding acting and like my advice. My advice to you, don't judge yourself and don't get down on yourself. Be strong and support one another. You know, it can sometimes like be a competitive business when you're in an audition room and it's like there's a lot of people auditioning for the same role, but always be kind to people, because it's a hard business, and you have to, like, you know, it's a hard business. It's very large, but it's also really small. You'll find yourself going around like the same people all the time too. So supporting one another is so powerful, and it really helps. And believing in yourself, working hard, staying confident, staying true to who you are, appreciating everyone you meet, and really taking in what's on set. Like, just be a sponge when you're on set and learning everything. Being able to take direction is important. And knowing where you came from, please. And yeah, get started with getting comfortable with yourself and getting comfortable with acting crazy in scenes, and don't judge yourself. And be supportive to your friends. And then my overall advice is to check up on your friends. Stay true to who you are. Find yourself during this time of quarantine. Please wear a mask. Please, please, please wear a mask. Please vote. And take care of the environment. Mwah! Thank you, Kauai Con and Kauai Comic Con virtual crossover event. I am so happy I got to do this. I really appreciate it. Thank you to Hawai'i for supporting me over these years and just continuing to be amazing. I love you guys so much, and I am very grateful. Mwah. I love my home. I'm so proud. Thank you. It means the world to me, and yeah. And thank you. Bye!